Welcome to American Railway Volume 7. In this program, we take a look at various lines on a journey from the Ohio River in Kentucky northwards through to the shores of Lake Erie. We begin in the small industrial city of Ashland, which lies on the western bank of the Ohio River in northeast Kentucky on the border with Ohio. The city is situated on the CSX tracks to Cincinnati and is the site of a large steel manufacturing plant owned by AK Steel, which generates much freight traffic in the area. The manufacturing of pig iron in the mid-1800s started the city's industrial growth and the heavy industry surrounding it. Passing Amtrak's Ashland Station are CSX GP40-2 number 6460 and XGP30 Road Slug number 2294 and a short train of scrap metal for the nearby yard. Road slugs are semi-permanent attachments to mother engines such as seen here. They consist of just the locomotive body and traction motors but no engine, instead taking their power from the mother locomotive. The tracks here are ex-Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad metals. It later became part of the Chessie system and after various other mergers ended up as CSX Transportation. The original railroad was largely founded on the coal revenues from its operations in West Virginia as it expanded northwards into the Midwest. As well as mixed freight trains, long trainloads of coal wagons are common. In this view, a southbound working passes at just after 5 p.m. on the 30th of April 2009. Thank you. switcher type SW1001, number 1217, which belongs to AK Steel, is seen making a leisurely journey between two of the city's main yards on a set of coke wagons. We now fast forward around 4 hours to 10 o'clock at night, and we are on Winchester Avenue as this southbound grain train heads off into the night. With the headlights of CSX number 449 catching the falling rain, this southbound manifest passes by at just before 11:30. The following day, we are on the eastern side of the river in Ohio, as Norfolk Southern number 7593, running Bonnet first, heads a southbound local. We now move south of Ashland to Kenova, just over the border into West Virginia. This is another heavily industrialized area which owes much of its existence to the coal mining industry, where for years the mineral was shipped up from the West Virginia coalfields by rail and transshipped onto the barges for further transportation along the Ohio River. We are still on the CSX main line as we begin with this fortuitous shot of a CSX coal train passing underneath the Norfolk Southern line which crosses over the Ohio River. Running over the truss bridge that takes the Norfolk Southern route over the river is locomotive number 5575, hauling a single caboose. Running along CSX Kenova subtracks are this pair of AC44CWs, numbers 81 and 217. This route was also part of the Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad. We now move north along the Ohio to Lucasville, which lies close to the Scioto River. In a thunder hailstorm on the 11th of May 2009, numbers 8369 and 9352 had loaded coal hoppers north for Cleveland. We are now close to Barberville, West Virginia, some 20 miles east of Kenova, on the CSX tracks to Charleston. Struggling up the grade are numbers 415 and 811 on a loaded coal train from West Beach Creek, deep in the Logan coalfield. The same train is seen through Hurricane, where tracks were laid in 1873. The town was named after Hurricane Creek, which was itself named after a group of trees that were bent over in one direction. The area looked like it had been hit by a hurricane. Thank you. Moving northwards once again, we are now on the main CSX line east of Cleveland, close to the shores of Lake Erie. This was once Norfolk and Western Railroad tracks. Today the route sees cars, coal, oil, containers and mixed freight making up the majority of the traffic seen. CSX 7912 and 499 head this eastbound train of oil tanks on May the 3rd, 2009. We are now at Maple Street crossing in the town of Perry, as CSX numbers 4721 and 74 restart this westbound manifest. 8 freight trains were seen here in just under 2 hours.
Thank you.
At nearby Wood Road Crossing, a typical country affair, CSX numbers 5263, 5303 and 5357 head this westbound intermodal. Union Pacific also runs along this route. Here, with a set of coal empties, are numbers 7153 and 5870, heading back to the Powder River Basin coalfield. Thank you. This is the line running into Conneaut Docks. Bessemer and Lake Erie Railroad ST38 switches coal wagons. At Moorheadville, east of Erie, 5255 and 5333 head west. Tucked in behind the leading pair are 2443 and ST40-2 with 1006, an MT6 slug unit. In the opposite direction, a BNSF coal train is powered by 6216 and 9607, the latter in ex-Burlington Northern ST70 Mac. Finally in this section, we see Union Pacific 7049 paired with CSX 4521 passing close to the port of Conneaut, shortly after 11:30 on the 4th of May. Having retraced our steps, we are back in Kentucky to witness freight traffic on the Norfolk Southern main through to Tennessee and on the CSX line south from Cincinnati. We begin close to Sparta on the route to Louisville. Note the picturesque farm buildings with white roofs. In the opposite direction come 855 and 271. We now move to the southern part of the state to view trains running through the gorge at Kings Mountain and over the Trestle Bridge at South Fork. This is the old Cincinnati, New Orleans, and Texas Pacific Railroad, running through Junction City, which is now a subsidiary of Norfolk Southern. Originally built to the broader 5-foot gauge, it was converted to standard gauge in as little as 13 hours in 1886. Thank you. South of Junction City is King's Mountain, with this spectacular rock cutting. 9227 and 9037 head south. Just to the north of King's Mountain, there is the South Fork Trestle Bridge. Here, Norfolk Southern 8374, 9169 and 7544 crossed the structure with a loaded ballast train. Our final scene shows Norfolk Southern 9928 and 9239 heading south with an evening mixed container and manifest working. hope that in this programme you've enjoyed seeing some of the many and varied freight workings to be found in the Midwest of America. Thank you for watching.